everybody. It's Amber here for Tune In Tuesday with Hope, Healing Our Past Experiences. I just want to welcome you back again this week as we discuss the tough stuff, answer your questions, and share stories of hope. And so I really had been contemplating what I wanted to share as we were coming up on Mother's Day and just looking at it from that perspective. And I was thinking about the many different places I've been teaching and speaking the last couple of months, and I've been in a lot of schools and conferences and even doing ladies events and things like that. And there's been a question that I have began asking in almost every crowd that I speak, because I realize how impactful it is when we come to talk about prevention of childhood sexual abuse and also raising confident children, right? And so what mother doesn't want to raise confident children? Like, that's really our heart's desire, is to have the best for our children and to even do better for them than what we had. That's how most are, not all, but most, right? And so the question is, did your parents or whoever raised you, did they teach you the proper terms for your anatomy, right? They taught you, I'm sure, belly button and elbow and nose, but did they teach you the proper terms when it came to your male parts or your female parts, right? And so I'll ask that question, whether I'm with teenagers or I was just at a conference where it was, you know, all adults varying in age and ethnic backgrounds and even from around the world, right? And it was interesting because in about every crowd, whether I'm talking in a high school or a conference or wherever, there are only a few hands that go up that say, yeah, like my parents, they taught me the proper terms. Like, they called it penis and vagina, which to so many, those are bad words. Those are ucky words. Those are icky words. How dare we say that? What if I teach my child those words and they say them in church or at school or at grandma and grandpa's house? Oh my gosh. And it's like, why? And I had a woman come up to me at a conference and she says, I realized that I had not taught my younger children those words because I was afraid to make others uncomfortable. And she nailed it, right? Like, a lot of people, that's what it is. It's not that they are like withholding because they want less than or, no, they're afraid to make others uncomfortable. Let me tell you what you should want for your child, your children, right? And so if you have somebody that is trying to touch your child inappropriately, let's use, in my mind, I have a four-year-old son that is like confident, right? And so if somebody tried to touch him, he would say something to the effect of, hey, why are you touching my penis? Do you think that adult or other child, because it's not just adults who hurt children, it's other children who hurt children, do you think they would continue doing what they're doing, or would they pause? Would they reconsider? Because they realize that this child is empowered and equipped with the tools to tell, right? Because what happens is we steer away from it for fear of making others uncomfortable, fear of it makes us feel icky and all these things, because there's a stigma with it. But like, the truth is like, it's your body part, whether it's your elbow, your nose, your belly button, your penis, your vagina. Like, it's not a bad word. It's not. It's equipping your kids to be confident to communicate about their own body, right? And so it's so important that they are equipped to communicate, because that's the only way they have to tell, really, right? And so how frustrating is it to try to communicate something and not have the proper language skills to be able to communicate it clearly? So maybe you've had a slang name or a fun term or whatever else, and you know, I want you to picture in your head a child trying to communicate to their mom, to their teacher, to somebody who cares about them, about what's going on, and they're trying to tell that person that, you know, so-and-so touched my fill in the blank. Is it going to make sense? Is it going to get minimized or dismissed? Is it not going to be heard at all because it's confusing, right? And so, like, I want to tell you, you can be confident in helping to prevent, to overcome, and to protect sexual abuse by simply empowering them with words to communicate about their own body, right? Don't be afraid. It's not a bad word. Say it with me. Penis, vagina, not bad words, all right? I hope you all have a great Mother's Day and that you're encouraged that you can be bold and that you can be the change for your family that you want and that you can overcome these things that were meant to destroy you and your family for generations to come. See y'all next week.